So how do you tell a story quite like Peckham Rye? Well, with all good stories, you best start here, the beginning. And at the beginning of 200 years of master family tailoring, there was this fella, Tommy McCarthy. Now, this one didn't mess about. If you're a 14-year-old Irish boy, you best have something to keep you busy, because this part of town weren't a place to be idle. Lucky for Tommy, he had his head screwed on, and he got himself busy with the colonial army, otherwise known as the legendary East India Company. Big day for a young boy, you might think. Tommy knew that too. In fact, to celebrate, as per family tradition, he took a colonial brass halfpenny, punched a hole in it, aiming just left of the Bengal tiger, which was the emblem of the regiment, and he kept it on his watch chain till the day he died. Now, not only did this boy see the world, he learned a good thing or two about fine tailoring. Now, Tommy soon started a family, and our story is picked up with his little one, Charlie McCarthy. Charlie found his feet in tailoring at the tender age of 9, helping spread the reputation of the family trade. Following in his father's footsteps, Charlie took this skill for stitching on the road, joining the army and tailoring all over the globe. Even the regimental banner got the McCarthy touch when he was in Gibraltar in June of 1859 with the Fusiliers. Before long, Charlie became a corporal. He saw the whole world, but he brought it all back to where it mattered most, Peckham. He took his first commission out of the army over a drink or two on Blackfriars Street, and he made fine work with a tape measure, there and then in the saloon bar. These days you get arrested for that. Anyway, business was good and Charlie was doing the family proud. The whole family got stuck in, and it stayed like that till the day he died. John, Charlie's son, didn't have it so lucky. Bright spark he was, preparing to take on the whole world with a needle and thread. Trouble was, the world wasn't ready for it, and the market took a nosedive, to say the least. But the McCarthys won't be beaten, though. He kept the skill going on, and he never gave up. This brings us to Charlie's daughter, Catherine. Her and John did a fine job. Money was tight, but you can't put a price on reputation, and these kids were wealthy in that. Making the finest hats and hat ribbon around was all well and good, if you had somewhere to wear them. But the unemployment queue at the town hall wasn't exactly a catwalk. To make matters worse, the only hats the boys were wearing were covered in mud, 6 metres down a trench. Also, not good for business. Watching the bigger boys go off to fight the Germans in World War I was Frankie, and he wasn't going to let Britain go without fine tailoring. No way, mate. Frankie leads us on to Paul, the honorary chairman of Peckham Rye that we know today, and the late Helen, his wife. A story that's took our family round the world and to death's door, but always ended up not far from the start, stronger every time. The world may have changed since Tommy McCarthy's day, but some things stay the same. Peckham Rye. Who wears, wins.